One of those supporters included Randy Weaver of the infamous Ruby Ridge standoff in Idaho back in 1992. He, along with many other supporters, followed the Brown story on the internet, where the couple maintained a website and radio broadcast that profiled this showdown from the beginning.
January 18, 2007, convicted. Ed and Elaine Brown found guilty of evading hundreds of thousands of dollars in taxes. Taxes they say there's no law requiring them to pay.
You cannot tax my labor. They're under the assumption that they can tax anything from any means that's available.
From the time of the conviction, Ed Brown has been at the couple's Plainfield property. His wife, Elaine, joined him there in February. The couple has never left the home since.
I wanted to bring this to the attention of the general public, so the only way we could do that was through civil disobedience and say, hey, okay, let's stop paying taxes for a while and get everyone's attention.
In April, word of their sentence, 5 years in prison, hundreds of thousands of dollars in fines. It would be a few months later when Ed would next talk to us, refusing to leave his house.
What court case? Not my court case. I don't have a court case. They have something they fabricated out of thin air.
It was during the same interview where Brown started to talk about a standoff, telling us it may not end peacefully.
Do I look like I'm dangerous? But I could be. I could be.
Weeks would go by before we'd next hear from the Browns, holding a press conference surrounded by supporters, including Randy Weaver.
They're coming in. If they come in, we're dead. That's it. We will not be arrested. We will not volunteer to go into their prison for a non-crime. We have committed no crimes.
So we don't submit.
We told them we either walk out of here free or we die. That's it.
Contrary to that statement, we're told this standoff ended peacefully last night. That press conference there was the last time that we would meet with Ed and Elaine Brown. After that point, the media was no longer allowed on the property. In the newsroom, I'm Josh Davis, WMUR News 9.